Thank you. It's my pleasure to be here and speak about Alexandria and my project description of Alexandria for the second time in Sweden. Today I will tell you about Mediterranean city. You hear me?
Yeah.
Mediterranean city and all ancient Mediterranean city with a very, very rich history and heritage, and which facing a serious problem of losing its built heritage. And I will tell you more also about description of Alexandria and why we need such an initiative to keep our heritage survive, and what we do, what we exactly do, and what we're working on. And finally, it will be the aims and the objectives to achieve through implementation of the project. Every ancient city has its own characteristics that makes it unique and special. And when we talk about Alexandria since the construction almost 24 centuries ago, it has been always the pluralism and the cultural diversity and the interaction between different social divisions. That's what makes its very, very rich history, full of achievement and a rich heritage. As with Paris in the 20s and Tanger in the 50s or San Francisco in the 70s, Alexandria is well known for a specific period of its modern history, which is the 100 years between 1860 and 1960. Which shaped the current image of the city as we know today, when Alexandria became the gateway of Egypt and the point of contact between different civilizations and culture, and also became the culture of the hub of cosmopolitanism in Egypt. Alexandria is a linear city. Actually, we call it the sandwich, as it's bordered between the Mediterranean Sea to the north and the Lake Mareo to the south. And the maximum depth of the city reaches in some distant circuits around only 6 kilometers. Since the 70s, the population of Alexandria was exploded. And the Mediterranean image of this city had been changed forever. Many of the older buildings were demolished and replaced by sterile modern structures. Then after the revolution of 2011, more than 27,000 buildings were erected, unfortunately, most of them illegally. As you see here, this is a typical height of the old houses in Alexandria, and this is the typical height of the new houses, which was built in the same plot, but unfortunately, it's 15 floors, using the same infrastructure. The current image of the city, as I said, had been completely changed, and the urban fabric was changed dramatically, I think. The architectural theme of the city was deformed forever, and unfortunately, it can't be recovered. Very, very few places in some certain districts which still keep its old character. And of course, you know, by losing our built heritage, we're also losing our history and memories. We're losing our identity and traditions, because buildings are not only some walls and bricks, it's simply the containers of our memories. Through history, many causes have led to this major problem, but I would like only to mention the most important reason is the lack of information and the fragmented data about our built heritage, especially in the absence of a national archive and archives and a professional documentation. If these buildings were well documented, they would have a better chance to survive. Unfortunately, every attempt to explore our cultural heritage is always constrained by the availability and accessibility to the old and historical materials and documents. However, a main source of our history are the documents done by the travelers describing their own experiences in Alexandria between the 16th and the 18th century, while the 19th and the 18th remains often neglected. So, almost we don't know everything about our modern built heritage. And that is what we are exactly trying to do in description of Alexandria. Because I believe is a great source of information is depending on the first-hand oral investigation. And of course, it's in our case. And in an extensive field surveys to the sites and the buildings. So description of Alexandria is trying to cover this point, which is a cultural and artistic documentation studies that seeks to document Alexandria and its culture and architecture situation, and to present a an actual image of today's Alexandria and the remains of the past. Actually, when I started the project, this project almost 2 years ago, I was inspired by three main relevant works. Firstly is the book Description de l'Egypte, which was done by the French expedition in Egypt. This book was published in French between 1809 and 1829, and it was consists of 11 volumes. That volume is that big, each one. Almost it's described everything in Egypt. This book was published in Deutsch in Copenhagen in 1772. It was a kind of a travel book describing many Arab countries, including Egypt. And lastly is four volumes, also that big, of drawings and description for many buildings and monuments and sites in Egypt. It was done by the Scottish painter David Roberts, and it remained a great reference in Egypt. And I guess it was the last complete visual document done in Egypt. Before I tell you how we work, I just would like to refer how I started, because at the very beginning was in 2009. When I was working on a research and renovation project for a small fisherman village in Alexandria, where I did an investigation and questionnaire with the people who live there to understand their problems. And then I translated these problems into an architectural solution. But I didn't present the final product as a typical architecture drawings. It was just artistic drawings. And that was fascinating because everyone there started to recognize his new house if you compare it with the old one, and to memorize it. And that made me think that art is a good tool to present and to give a quick message. So since that time, I started to draw more and more and record more buildings from Alexandria till 2012, when I started a sketching group. The aim was to explore Alexandria and to teach young architects how to draw, how to sketch, because you know it's the language of architecture and how you express your ideas. After a year of working, I had a really big set of my own drawings, which all have one theme and telling or describing one story. Actually, they were describing Alexandria. And I wanted to let the other Alexandrians know about our built heritage and about what we really have. So I tried to collect them in a book, and I picked the name Description of Alexandria. But I couldn't find any publisher, because the idea was still uncompleted, not complete, and a little bit vague. It was just an art book. So I spent the next following months studying some relevant ideas and projects, till I set up a framework of a national documentation project where all Alexandrians from different disciplines could engage and contribute to saving our built heritage, or our heritage as a whole. And we have started from one of the oldest sites in Alexandria, which is Pharos Island. Actually, it was an island and connected to the shore here by a bridge called Hepta Stadium, but through time it became a shaped this land. But now, standing in the state of the Pharos Island, the fort of Kite Bay, which was built in the 15th century. Basically, we are working on two models. Firstly, it's a book, and secondly, a journal consists of several issues. But the book is describing buildings and sites according to a certain plan and following a map. It's divided into volumes and chapters. We are working now in volume one, which is documentation for Alexandria within the old borders of the city. Chapter one, which we are started with, is the studies for the waterfront of the eastern harbor of the old city of Alexandria, where it starts from the citadel of Kite Bay, here in the left, and ends at the new library of Alexandria. But due to our limited manpower, resources, and time, we have managed to cover only 21 buildings of 120. And hopefully we could finish chapter one by the end of 2016, I guess. While the journal is consists of several different issues, everyone studies only one building, depending on some qualitative values like the age and the history of the building, the function, or some architecture features, the architecture style, or the values, even cultural or religious, and of course the folklore. But in both the book and the journal, we are following the same structure, which allows us to document both the tangible and the intangible heritage. Through describing the building and its cultural background and environment surrounding as well. These sections are the architecture drawings and sketches, the written description and the memory of the place, and finally, the photography archive. If we start by the architecture drawings and sketches, as you know, the sketch is a 2D representation for a 3D environment. So we try to draw many and different perspectives from many and different views to make sure that we have covered all the building. And that leads to a greater accuracy in the extracted information. Then we go for the 2D architecture drawings, of course, if it's available, to access the building and to get to draw these architecture drawings, which is plans and elevations. Then we go for the details of the building. We draw every detail, its motifs and decoration icons, the openings, windows, doors, and balconies. The second chapter section is the written description and history, where we start to analyze the building and describe its architectural style, the structure system, the current state and condition of the building. Then we study its history from all the available books and researches. And also we refer to the old maps to identify exactly when was this building built and who were the main owners, the original owners of it. Were there, as I told you, Alexandria was a cosmopolitan city. So many buildings belong to different nationalities with different professions. But through getting to know this information, that leads us to the third section, which is equally important for both specialist and non-specialist reader. And we call it the memory of the place, where we write articles extracted from investigation and the questionnaire we do. In this section, we write articles extracted from questionnaire we do with the users of the buildings. These articles are telling the unwritten history of the building, somehow like the oral history, which is never recorded before. And besides these articles, you will find illustrations, which is telling the same story. So we present different kind of materials targeting different levels of readers and receivers, depending on their education or their backgrounds. Finally is the photography archive, which gives another level of details about the building and the important aspects of it, like the physical state and the finishing materials and textures. So, as I told you, our big problem is the fragmented data and information about our built heritage. So our main aim goal is to describe the current and the former architecture, urban and cultural heritage of Alexandria. I guess description of Alexandria is not a fully professional architecture documentation, or at least till now, but in our case, it's more than valuable because most of the time we start from scratch. We collect new information that were never exist. We produce new visual memory. And that could be a good start for another researcher or another architect, or a start to build on more professional archives. I think more than 2 months ago, I got a contact from well-known Egyptian architect, a consultant architect, who would like to know more information about one villa we documented before in order to try to convince both the government and the owner to convert it from a vacant house to a cultural center. And that is one benefit of what we are doing, because there were no information about this building. Secondly, we are aiming to spread the awareness about our cultural heritage, and to engage the society in preserving their own legacy before we lose it forever. The intention is to romancing the past through the integration between art and within the process of preserving the cultural heritage. it's a fact, you know, that we remember things better when they are attached to a good picture. And it's much better if you are the one who draws this picture. Thirdly, it's not only about the built heritage, it's about history. Because many buildings in Alexandria were built and designed by famous leading international architects like Mario Rossi and August Bray. For example, this villa, was, which is Amprum Villa, it was the house of the British writer Lawrence Durrell, who was the author of Alexandria Quartet and was shortlisted twice for the Nobel Prize for Literature. This villa is in a really, really bad condition and is waiting to be demolished soon, unfortunately. One another good example is during the Second World War. There were a great battle that took place in a place in Alexandria called El Alamein in 1943. And this hotel, which is Cecil Hotel, had witnessed the meetings of the British Prime Minister Winston Churchill with his field marshals during this battle. And this is not only the good example in Alexandria. We have many, many buildings. Last thing is, we still producing art, and art could be a good material to promote our city and to promote tourism into the city, our cultural tourism, and to generate investment to get a good resource which could sustain our built heritage. Through the implementation of the project, we could turn every Alexandrian citizen into a memory device who will keep our history and identity in their minds and soul, and will pass it from generation to generation. It's a journey to relive our past, or we can call it to recover our future. Thank you.